You're ready, ma'am. You can go ahead and begin.
Everybody's had at least one family member who's passed, correct? This isn't anything new. It's been going on, well, since forever. And my verse, Revelation 2:10, has helped me through some of those situations. Revelation 2:10 says that, hold on. Revelation says, do not fear, but you are about to suffer. Behold, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison, that you may be tested, and for 10 days you will have tribulation. Be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. The second part was more what I was aiming for, but I guess there was more. So I also could add other stuff about it. Two summers ago, my grandpa died. It was really tough for me. I didn't know him very well because he was my step-grandpa, and he lived in California, and we only visited him twice, but it was just hard seeing my aunts and my uncle and my stepdad, and even my grandma. She was torn up for about a whole year because of it, and it was just really hard for all of us. He was a very special guy for all of us. He helped pay for me to come here. He let us drive his new Dodge Dart, which was very exciting for us because we literally go everywhere in a minivan. So having a car to drive around is pretty fun and new. For me, I almost have the luxury of remembering him as when he was younger. And, well, not younger, but not all sick and stuff. Knowing that he was a good Christian, or just Christian in general, I knew that he went to heaven, where he could see his family and, you know, but... the first part of the verse, I thought, hey, everybody goes through times of trouble where you're tested, and you have doubts, and you can pray and God will help you through them. I have verses that kind of give a similar message. The first one is James 1, verse 12. Blessed be the man who remains steadfast under trial, for when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life. Also kind of saying that if you believe and if you faith is strong, you will go to heaven. The other one I have was Matthew 10:22, verse 22. You will be hated by all for my name's sake, but one who endures to the end will be saved. Also conveying the message. Some background information about the book of Revelation was it was a letter written by Paul to the churches and in Asia. On your handout, I have a map of the different churches. Smyrna was the church that this part of the letter was for, and that's why I circled it. Put the link. Oh, yeah, also, there's ruins of what people think the church was on there, too. You can put it away now if you want to. And the Church of Smyrna was being persecuted by the government because the government needed a scapegoat for why it was not doing well. So, you know, the Christians are a minority. what St. Paul did was he wrote a letter to the churches, and theirs was specifically for that help that they needed. The first was given to me by my stepdad for confirmation, and it's just helped me through some very tough times. I think about some things, like, you know, I miss those who have passed and stuff, and I look at the verse, even in just regular times, when I'm not sad about that, or just sad about something else, and I think it's okay, God can help. Those who aren't Christian, during times of health, they can turn to family or friends, and they can also help. And yeah, that's about it.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause.